the network.
So this is the highlight of my festival, and instantly, just right off the bat, Adventure ATL Fest, Memory Lane versus Event Recap. You get what I'm saying? Or something like that. So you're already positioning people within a brand with certain language that you're using. And then I'll just go through it a little bit, then we'll talk about it at the end. Not gonna be able to change the phone, but you know.
Hey! You know what it was? You psyched up.
And turn your phone back around. All right, so just overall, just the idea of narrative, right? You see how there sometimes there were words that led and guide how you thought and told you. Sometimes you can break from that, but then even the just snippet where it had the background music, new Frieza, and going throughout the actual event, that was directed to take people through the feels of things and how. So instead of just a recap, I created an entire narrative and feel where you felt like that's, you felt deeper than just most event recaps. You know what I mean? Like you're really like seeing yo from an inside perspective. Even that part where it's the girl talking about Adventure ATL Fest, and I collected basically all the stories that other people did, because now you don't get just event recap, which is dope for premiering an event or showing people stuff like that, but also showing other people's first person perspective, like things like that. You know, it's kind of equivalent to you having people do the fan love shout outs, right? And collecting those type of things, it just adds layers, and you're taking people through an experience where I could have just did, hey, there's a recap or shout out everybody, and then one little quick 1 minute video or something like that and called it a day. And I even have a long extended video version that's like 4 minutes long, 5 minutes long, I think. But that's what using it to take people on a full narrative and story. You have to plan that out, right? Beforehand, what am I going to show? What am I going to direct them on? What do I want to say? But that's what using it to do a story looks more like. And I need to do that a lot more. I had like the, where you see this ugly FAQ, right? That was, I had a full plan to get to finish all these in January when I added all these up. I just haven't yet. So like I said, I got to take my own medicine. I know what to do. I just be busy doing shit, but I get it. So I understand that it's hard and it's another thing to think about, but you, once you put in that creative work, it's there. Like even this testimonial thing, we're about to go to the first one. Like this one probably shouldn't be the first one, to be honest, but that was when I hit. So, like, if you read my text and everything about it, blah, 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 and it, so you're reading everything, and then it's taking people to do testimonials with context, my own commentary along with it, as opposed to just having a whole bunch of pictures and screenshots. You know what I mean? Like, you have to always ask that, you have to always ask, not ask, you have to always add that additional layer. And that's going to make the story powerful. You have to tell people what to think, right? Like, me saying y'all got me using the word gems, and then people start to notice the word gems over in all these things. People could very well read this without knowing gems. This is the equivalent of a headline when y'all see the headline exercises and stuff like that in week four, but how reading a headline literally positions how you see everything afterwards, right? You're telling them what to focus on, right? Like all that stuff, it matters and it adds up. You know what I mean? It all matters. So keep that in mind when it comes to how you creatively go about your, what's the word I'm looking for? Yeah, how you creatively go about using your highlights. Once you know what your narrative is, now it's up to you to start telling that story. If you don't control your narrative, other people will. And it might not necessarily be a narrative that you like. So you have to create the narrative, make it super clear, and then go from there.
Because those could be just like a summary for your page, basically, right? Like most people are starting to click on those story highlights more than scrolling down, I think, right?
In a lot of ways, you know, I can't give you a number and say most people, but I know a lot of people do that. And it's up to you to create intrigue because it's way more valuable. It's hard to really just stick to telling a specific story through every single one of these boxes and blocks because you really need to show other stuff in this. Mm-hmm. But in this is a controlled environment. I literally have all your attention while I'm looking at this. So I can tell you what to think now, what to think here, what to think here. Like, and I continually keep you in experience, and I could tell a full story and be done. And I suggest you guys don't necessarily make this as long as I've made it. There's reasons my mind is so long. But outside of just for people seeing it for promo purposes.